Hi, I'm Andrew Ferguson. On behalf of all of us here at Think Broadband, we'd like to wish you a Merry Christmas. At this time of year, we often see lots of reports of broadband slowing down. The Christmas season means that more people are at home with their families, so broadband networks can be quite busy. But did you know that the problems sometimes are even closer to home than you think? If you have a broadband service delivered for a telephone line, and that means most services apart from Virgin Media cable services, you may find at this time of year that your broadband slows down through radio interference or sometimes even completely cuts out for a few seconds. The sources of this radio interference can be many different things. It can be TVs, it can be your boiler switching on and off, it can be almost anything that's electrical. But one of the most common problems at this time of year is Christmas lights, particularly those where the lights are blinking. There's a neat trick you can use to detect radio interference with your broadband, and that's to use an AM radio. The reason an AM radio is useful is because broadband and AM radio share the same set of frequencies. Although, of course, you have to make sure it's not a DAB radio because they use a completely different set of frequencies. To test this, switch your radio to the AM band and tune it to around 600 kHz. Try putting it next to an electrical circuit, such as your light switch. Once this works, put the radio close to or under your Christmas tree. And switch on your Christmas tree lights. If you can hear a difference in the static noise from the radio, it's possible that this will cause interference with your broadband signal, especially if your router is near or the telephone line runs by the Christmas tree. We would recommend, if possible, that you avoid placing your Christmas tree and Christmas tree lights near to your broadband router or telephone line. Adjoining properties, of course, can also be another source of interference, but generally, as those are a few metres away from your own property, the chances of it causing problems are a lot less. We hope you find this tip useful, and we look forward to giving you more advice over the next year on how to avoid broadband problems. And hopefully in years to come, once we've all switched to fully fibre optic broadband connections, i.e. fibre to the home, this whole problem of radio interference on our broadband connections will completely vanish.
Find this tip helpful
and then they reel it out. So look, see, this is a problem you all have with your copper-based broadband. Yep, you're thinking exactly the same.